Car Chronicles 1. Marriage. I can speak on it. I've been married for 6 years. It's gonna go on 7 this year. It's okay for your significant other to have privacy. It's okay for your significant other to go on trips alone. Okay? It's okay to have trust in your significant other. Because you can't always go everywhere with your significant other. And let me speak on female position. You can't be hanging out with your husband and his boys. That don't look right. Okay? Let him be. And you let you be. Because at the end of the day, y'all both coming home to the same house. And y'all sleeping on the same bed. And I'm not saying I don't have any crazy tendencies, because I do. But at the end of the day, like, it's just, I feel like marriage has boundaries. And if you don't let that man be a man and he don't let you be a woman, then it's not going to work out. There's no such thing as trust and things like that. Granted, if your husband cheated on you while y'all was married, child, I say this. It's not, nobody get married to get a divorce. You know, nobody get married to get a divorce. And if you can handle it, then handle it and continue your marriage and fix it or whatever. But don't be in the marriage after he cheated on you and then you come out and act all crazy and gotta suspect every inch, every mile he go, because that's not healthy. Babe, you losing yourself. Find yourself another relationship. Because like I said, it's not healthy. If you're gonna stay in the marriage, fix it. Communication is key. Communication is key. Let's make that clear. Trust is key. Boundaries is key. Respect is key. Trust me, you'll have a good relationship. I've been with my husband for 7 years, married for 6. We had our ups and downs, but guess what? We made it work. We communicate. We do what we gotta do for our children, and that's it. Because at the end of the day, yes, you have in-laws or whatever, but you ain't married the in-laws. You ain't married your significant other. And that's the only person that you need to be worried about. If you got in-laws that like you, okay, cool. If you don't have them, okay, cool. Your spouse and your children. That's all it comes down to at the end of the day. Because you don't live with your mama-in-law, you don't live with your mama, you don't live with your daddy-in-law, you don't live with your daddy, you don't live with no in-laws or you know, your family. And if you do, they still need to mind their goddamn business about your marriage, because it ain't even about them. Okay.